TheBarLive.com. You're welcome to our show. Holy crap, I am Big Dave right here with you. TheBarLive.com. You're at the bar with Big Dave. Got the lovely Mel right next to me. And Lane to my far left. And, of course, Jimmy behind the bar. Behind the board tonight. Or behind the bar.
He is behind the bar.
We're behind everything.
Good God almighty. Sorry, we're supposed to start at 7 o'clock. It is 7 effing 45.
Yep.
And so if there's actually anybody still listening
it's
who thinks the
fault.
Show was going to go on today, congratulations and welcome to our table. I'm a little hacked off. It took me an hour and 10 minutes to get here today.
Traffic sucked.
Super bad. I mean, I really, it was that bad. I mean, if you can't tell, I'm a little hyped up. I'm a little excited. I'm a little upset. All right, and then when we got here, you know, a spur-of-the-moment meeting had to take place. Hey, so everybody was waiting on me and the rest of the people.
Really funny that just happened, dude.
Well, hurry up, because I got a lot of crap to do in a very short amount of time. What is it?
I put my cigarettes in my side pocket, okay?
And
so Mel goes, she's like, hey, and I had been talking about how big my Johnson
was. Oh, so she thinks, okay.
She grabbed that, and she goes,
yeah.
And it was hot, too. And I
that's great. And we haven't even started drinking yet.
I know. It was all, well, yeah, I started drinking a long time ago. I mean,
speaking of drinking,
I was drinking in traffic.
Yeah. speaking of drinking, our sponsors tonight, of course, you know, Boone's Farm Strawberry Wine,
Benchmark,
and of course, Benchmark. We want to thank them for
giving us free liquor.
Yeah, free liquor and lots of great advertising. And of course, also you can also check out our other sponsor if you want to get some really cool tight shirts for your babe.
Yeah, revolutionlane.net.
And really good yoga pants. Make your ass look fantastic.
I look fantastic in those yoga pants, by the way. Thank you for sending them to me.
No problem.
I think they're a little small, though, for me. Because I sent you
a 3X. But it's a women's 3X.
They're so comfortable.
Yeah, I got a little muffin top hanging out action going there. So
well, that's going to be with any pants that you wear. So I don't think it's the actual yoga pants.
Oh, sorry, man. But you know, I like them though. They're nice and tight, and
they make your butt look good.
They help me breathe too.
Oh yeah.
Okay. So anyway, hey, listen up. I run across something here today, and since of course I was like cussing, you know, like a sailor on the way here today. Because I was so pissed off about how long it took me to get here. I was thinking about a video that someone turned me on to. By the way, one of our listeners, Aaron, turned me on to this video. And it's a thing on YouTube called Angry Grandpa. Have you guys heard of this guy?
No.
Okay, this guy's got bipolar, right? And, you know, my wife has bipolar, right? So, I mean, I can kind of relate to the fits of anger that happen sometimes, as well as the fits of happiness that happen sometimes with a bipolar person.
I'm not bipolar.
So you're really not?
No, I am.
Okay, never mind. Just leave it alone.
That's schizophrenic.
Yeah, you're right.
Come on.
You're off. You're on the wrong trail, man.
Completely wrong. Like, really?
So anyway, to get it out of my system, I'm going to play this quick clip here, this quick audio clip of Angry Grandpa for you, because this guy basically gets it out of my system about how I feel today.
I don't know.
Now, just so you know, he's really hacked off. He's sitting in front of his computer, and you know how you get those stupid, those people who send you those links to a game to play on Facebook with them? Hey, come be a part of this game. It's really cool, dude. We can play together because we have no life at all. So let's all get together on Facebook and play stupid-ass games. Anyway, this is somebody sent Angry Grandpa one, and he's sitting in front of the computer, and this is what he does.
Fuck you. I don't give a goddamn. Every time I get out, it's these goddamn games. Fucking games. Somebody wants a goddamn son of a motherfucker. I'll give you a goddamn heart. Motherfucker, I'll give you a
what are you talking about?
Oh, man, they got some kind of goddamn. Who gives a fuck? Somebody found some kind of riff.
This is what I sounded like 35 minutes ago in traffic.
Speckled motherfucking billy goat dog or where the fuck it is. Oh, they got a plow to goddamn. They ain't even got a goddamn. Get the fuck. Them motherfuckers.
Oh, what the fuck are you doing?
I'm goddamn tired of it.
He's tearing off his shirt.
Every goddamn time I get out, the motherfucker drives me crazy.
What are you, Hulk Hogan? What was that?
The motherfucker drives me crazy. I don't give a fuck about a little speckled motherfucker in.
Their application.
I don't got. Shut up. I don't care. They got. They want to join some goddamn mafia war games. But I ain't getting down on no goddamn Italians. But every time I get old, man, look at this shit. It's the same shit. It's the same motherfucking shit. Who gives a f***? Who gives a f***? You know, goddamn person plays these motherfucking games, man. They ain't got no goddamn life.
He ripped your shirt.
That's my shirt.
You don't have, man.
I don't give a f***. F*** your shirt. I'm just tired of this goddamn f***. Tired of it. I'm tired of this shit. I'd like to give this one job without somebody sending me a goddamn quit.
It actually starts getting better.
You know someone.
You ready?
Man, f*** this shit. I can't talk to you. Last night, man.
Oh, God, I feel better already.
You know, someone should really tell him that you can block those
from
your Facebook.
God, I feel so much better. Yeah, I don't think
it
does make, I mean, that's exactly what I felt like doing a little while ago in traffic. I swear I was that hacked off. Takes me usually 20 minutes to get here, an hour and 10 minutes. And you guys dealt with the same crap today?
Well, no, it took me 15 minutes to get from Plano to here. Like, new world record, I'm telling you. My baby.
That's because everybody's over here.
My baby.
Well, then why were you late?
Because my babysitter was late, so I walked out the door at 20 to 7, and I'm like, dude, I'm running late. And then I realized that your phone is like retarded right now, so it's not working.
Yeah.
So I texted Jimmy. I'm like, running late. Literally got here in 15 minutes. I went straight down George Bush. Don't ask me what speed I was doing.
All right, so listen up. Right here, I just got an email from Like Bridges We Burn. We were planning on having him on the show today. It says, hey there, Big Dave. This is Aaron from Like Bridges We Burn here regarding our lack of presence at your cast this evening. Let me apologize on our behalf for the unprofessionalism.
Yeah,
however, I hope we can still work together.
Nope,
sorry
you're
again.
Done.
Sorry again for taking your time.
Sorry, you're done.
I don't
That's
know, man.
It, man, we got a long list.
We do have a long list of guys, and I'm not gonna wait in line.
You could have like edited that down a little
bit. No like, email, no nothing. I even emailed him and told him. I said, guys, look, if you have any problems, my phone's gonna be. You can email me. I gave him my email number. Look, I understand things come up, but they could have emailed me or some crap, all right? I'm sorry. I've got a lot of people waiting in line to be on this podcast. As a matter of fact...
You're so full of shit.
No, as a matter of fact, I've got a Grammy-nominated guy. A Grammy Award winner who's going to be on the show next week, who is one of the biggest names in Spain. And he's going to be here in our studio hanging out with us. He's a really cool guy. I'm not going to tell you who he is. I'm just going to leave it there because I'm going to announce it tomorrow.
Dude,
okay?
No hablo español.
Yeah, it's going to be cool, man. He's a really cool guy, though. I've talked to him many occasions. He lives here in America, but he's really big in Spain. Does a world tour every year.
I'm huge in Japan.
Yeah, I know. I'm huge in, like, Arkansas.
Yeah.
I'm really big in Australia.
I don't know.
Does that count?
No, it does. By the way, you're looking hot tonight. I want you to know that little skirt you're wearing is just driving me crazy today. Yeah.
I didn't get a chance to change from
work.
And
I'm not into Aborigines, so
I didn't get
that's a compliment.
A chance to change from work.
That is wrong,
dude.
So this
is my work attire.
I just want
What's wrong with that?
I want to be on the record saying that I'll bone any race.
Nah.
Well.
I hear they don't. Do you douche?
So, what?
I'm just curious. I've heard that certain Aborigine tribes don't do things like
You're
that.
You're not supposed
no,
to do that
I
anymore.
I do something called showering. So, my vajayjay is very nice and clean. Thank you very much.
My vajayjay is clean, too.
Jesus
Me too.
Christ, really? Do
yeah.
you douche? Like,
yes.
are
yeah.
you a douche?
He is a douche,
I'm just curious.
Actually.
It was just a question.
Really?
Good Lord, chill
You're
out,
not
man.
Supposed to do that anymore.
But that's
it's
just
like
going, Dave,
you.
Do you anal bleach? Like, really?
I don't see what the point would be in me doing that. Really? I mean,
well, you couldn't find it anyway.
Say when was the last time you'd seen
yeah.
it?
That's not very nice.
You know, if you put a mirror on the floor, you might just be able to see your junk.
So you guys heard about the Heart Attack Grill? This was his last week. I know I'm catching up on everything because we missed
last
week.
Yeah, but that actually happened a few weeks ago.
No, it didn't really. It
yeah.
was that far.
Yeah, it was. Yeah.
It
was
I thought it was last week.
No,
no.
It was
no. Wait, this is another one because this is the third one this year.
Oh. Well,
like,
who
really
cares,
I'm sorry.
You know?
No, because I really wanted to go, and according to this guy, but of course this guy is kind of funny. The Heart Attack Grill customer collapses while eating a double bypass burger and smoking.
If you go
at
to
the same time,
any place called Heart Attack Grill and you die, that's on you. Like,
well,
seriously?
It's the last guy that did it. He was eating the triple bypass burger, and they showed this thing on TV.
It's like
3 patties, each one was a pound.
They're beautiful.
It had like
they are a thing of beauty.
It had like a pound of bacon on it. It yes. had like, you know, cheese, mush. I mean, it was like it was like a Dagwood burger.
Damn.
And I'm sitting there going, you know, I can't even
Are you still able to eat free there?
Yeah, I can still eat free there. If you're over 300 pounds, you can eat
400.
No, I think it's like 3 or 350, I believe. I have the guy's phone number in my phone. If I could call him, I would. But maybe we can call him on y'all's phone or something, right?
What?
You can eat free there if you're fat?
Yeah. Yes, if you're really fat. Well,
really?
I mean, I shouldn't say that because I can eat free there. If you're a large fella or a lady, you can eat there.
No, why can't you just say fat? Why can't you just say if you're a big fat ass, you can eat here for free? I mean, why is it politically incorrect?
You little skinny bitch.
Well, you can't.
Some of us work out even though we're big, all right? It doesn't have to be all chub, all right? I'm not 100% body fat here.
Raising a burger to your mouth does not count as working out. I'm sorry, but it just doesn't.
But and look, I'm sure you're strong because you're carrying around all that weight. That builds muscle because...
Remember, like, 3 or 4 weeks ago, he was giving us lessons on how to get a six-pack? Maybe that's his, like, idea
That was going to the store to get a six-pack.
You're a dirty, smelly pirate hooker.
Yep, and I've even got the boots to match.
You know what? I'm going to take a break. But right before we do the break, I wanted to real quick get the phone number out there because I know we got some people want to call in.
It is 214.
Easy there, brother. Hold on a second.
214.
Let me wait till I cue you.
6-9.
I know we got some. I'm going to beat both of you guys. I swear to God.
Please. I like to be beaten.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Mm.
Fuck.
Oh, that's real good. Classy.
That was good. Good. That was really. Really
see
nice.
What I'm saying?
She just
dirty,
yeah, just
dirty pirate hooker.
We can edit that out in post. That won't be on the highlight reel.
No, it will be on the highlight reel.
All right, listen up. I know we got some people who are planning on calling in today. I hope they're still hanging out with us, even though the late start to the show.
214.
Please don't do that. Seriously, man. It sounds horrible when you play it back. It sounds like you're a total moron, and you don't know what the F a microphone is. F and four. You're stupid effing moron.
You always treat me like a moron, so. You know, anyways, the phone number is...
Go ahead, Tard.
The phone number is 214-736-3569.
Go to a break. Go to a break and shut them the hell up. Go to a break. Music, please, Jimmy.
3569.
I give up. Somebody shoot me in the head. Are we going to break or not? How many times I guess... Jesus, I don't want him to say another word.
I said he's so sweet.
God, if you're listening to this show, you guys are all idiots.
And we love you.
Oh,
The Bar Live. You're at the bar with Big Dave right here with us. Thank you for being right here with us. Once again, the phone number, you can give us a call at
214-736-3569.
Feel free to call in. Yeah, you know, I did that story, not the story. I did the thing on the angry grandpa because I ran across that because of a story that was sent to me led to it. And this particular story, I'm going to go ahead and read to you because he was like freaking out. I can't play the audio on the angry grandpa's reaction to this thing here because it was just way too filthy and they didn't have it edited out. So, but anyway, he was really upset about this video that's gone viral on I guess YouTube or whatever. It's these two chicks, I guess they're probably 16, 17 doing what they call double takes hot problems. You guys heard about this? It's called Double Takes Hot Problem. Do you have a mic over there, Jimmy? Okay. Have you heard of what we're talking about though?
Yeah. I have heard it. It's pretty funny.
Okay. Well, it's you guys. I'm sure most of you guys know. It's no secret that a couple of nights a week I run a karaoke show, and I'll tell you what. it is an adventure in itself, just seeing the kind of crazy crap and what people will actually do on a stage. It's amazing. But every once in a while, I run across somebody who will send me a story like this and say, you got to listen to these two chicks trying to do this. And it's called Double Takes Hot Problems, right? And I'm going to let you listen to these two chicks, all right? This is their video that they made. Looks like mommy and daddy's got a lot of money, okay? And they don't really have much to do. And so they're going to use mom and daddy's money to make really expensive music videos.
And mom and daddy probably tells them that they can do anything in the world, yeah, and they're great.
So exactly.
Is this like Meatball Problems on like Jersey Shore?
No. Just follow along. Just follow along. Afterwards, you can ask me questions if you're still too stupid to figure it out. Oh, bam! I get no response. Did you hear that? Oh, I actually made her silent. That never happens.
I know. That was impressive, actually.
Come on. You got to give me a fist on that one. That was awesome.
I'm going to give you a fist, but it won't be on your hand.
Now, if you want, I can
actually... I live for moments like that where I get complete silence because there's no reaction. What? Go ahead.
I am actually currently pulling the video if you want to run that.
No, I've got the video right here. I'm getting ready to play it. I got it
right
for audio.
No one's going to be able to see it on that, though.
Well, after we play it, you can put it on audio, okay? Are you saying, never mind, I get what you're
saying.
Trying to
say. He can put
it on the website, dumbass.
Okay, I'll give you that one.
Are you too stupid to figure it out?
Yeah, that's
you can
what
ask Jimmy questions when he's finished.
All right.
Bitch.
Do you feel better?
No.
Okay. Anything else?
I'll feel better when I punch you.
All right.
Swipe.
Let's do it. So you're going to play the video? All right, so we're going to switch over to the video on that. You guys can watch it for yourself. This is really gay, I swear to God. Can't even believe I'm playing it on the show, but it's just so stupid and horrible that I can't help myself. Yes, indeed. Yeah, is that the right one? You got it?
It's not playing the audio, actually. Sorry.
It's not playing the audio?
There it is.
Yeah, they're like in a limousine or something like that. Is that right? How gay is that?
Look at me and tell me the truth. What do you do when people don't know what we go through? They see my blonde hair, blue eyes in class, but they don't know I have a really big heart. Don't get me wrong, I know that I'm hot, but textbook perfection really takes a lot. Weird guys call my phone.
They suck.
Pretty bad.
Hot girls, we have problems too.
Really?
We're just like you, except we're hot.
Wow.
Who wrote the song? Do we know?
Obviously, they did. Like, oh my God.
Now, have you, I forget. Oh, yeah, it was Friday. Have you heard this song Friday?
Rebecca Black.
Yeah, so it's kind of like the same deal where you have like this pop company that will write the song, give you a video, like know what video they're going to do to it. They just need girls that are willing to pay to have it done. And so these guys apparently ended up doing this and didn't tweak their voice at all. Like it's literally just raw. And immediately I don't know if they didn't pay or what, but immediately they distanced themselves from it. The company did. They were like, hey, look, this is out there, but we aren't really claiming responsibility.
All right, well, let's listen to a little bit more. Maybe. As if we should. Alright, hold on a second. You know, keep this in mind. Turn down just a hair. Keep this in mind. This has had 2 million views on YouTube.
And how many death threats?
Yeah, well, I mean, everybody likes watching stupid. I only watch American Idol when they do the people that didn't make it on American Idol because they suck so bad.
I'm done. I can't hear any more of it. They're just annoying the hell out of me. God.
It burned my ears.
It really is bad. It really is bad.
Yeah, it was pretty bad.
Thanks to Aaron who
you know, you
told me about that.
You can go and like record the dumb bitches at your karaoke show that think they can sing and put them on YouTube and
I've
become
thought
viral.
About it. I really have thought about
it. Get them to sign
like
a waiver.
He thought about it a lot, and then he realized he didn't have enough money to buy a camera.
This is true. Actually, you know what I've been wanting to do is try to find somebody. And anybody out there listening, if you're interested, I would love to do a reality show because nobody's done a reality show where they follow a guy who does what I do for a living around.
Shh.
Yeah. I mean, trust me, there is a lot of drama on an everyday basis.
Okay, you just blew it.
No, I didn't, because
somebody's
going to
friggin' take it.
No, here's the reason
it.
Why, no. Here's the reason why nobody's right. done it with reality
you
show.
You have to, okay.
Listen to me. Hold on. Let me finish.
Let me preface this before you say
God
it.
Good God Almighty. Go ahead.
This is a verbal non-disclosure clause right here. If you hear this, you cannot disclose it, or we will have to have you killed. Okay, now go ahead.
What I was saying was, it doesn't matter if a reality show tries to go to some no-name karaoke guy, because it's not going to be good. They have to go to somebody who is a showman, like myself.
Big Dive.
Like myself, who is not only a showman, but is a complete a-hole to all of his customers. That's me.
You are an a-hole to, I mean,
that's right.
You've even been an a-hole to me.
That's right. I don't put up with crap from nobody. Look, I have rules on my show. I have rules on my stage. You break those rules, you're the F off my stage.
Listen,
I don't give a crap.
Think that he's like Heyman and that he's like laying the law down.
I'm not
really?
He-Man. I'm have not He-Man. Like, I am. It's my stage, my show, my rules.
Have you listened to our show lately? Like, you are not in control. And you are not in control of me.
Oh, well, thank you very much.
You
can be replaced.
Really?
Yeah.
I can leave now.
$20 says I can replace you by tomorrow.
Okay. Do it.
You ready?
Yeah.
You got $20?
Go for it.
I really need
I really need 20 bucks
right now.
I know that Taryn the Terrific is nowhere near as good as me.
I know this fat bitch, and she really thinks fat guys are hot.
There would not be enough room in the camera.
We don't need a fat bitch in here.
I can get her to wear no panties, too.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
My heart is beating faster thinking, wow, a fat chick in here with no panties on.
Speaking of fat chicks.
Yeah.
You guys heard about Jessica Simpson, right?
Yeah, she's not fat anymore. She squeezed that.
Oh, the hell she is.
She popped that thing out.
That bitch is still a tub of lard.
It was all water weight.
She gained like 108 pounds, man.
I know, but so what?
And the kid weighed like, did you hear about the kid weighed like 9 pounds? It's a chick, it's a girl, all right, little baby girl, and she called it Maxwell.
I ended up gaining 95 pounds with my pregnancy, and I lost it in 18 months. Yeah, I used to be a big bitch.
I gained 130 pounds when I got married, but I lost it in a divorce.
What the hell?
No, I'm just saying you're never the same after. You never, you know, the junk just don't work the same way after a kid.
That's not true.
My junk
that
is
not true.
Very nice and tight. Thank
yeah,
you.
It
I
is.
Do my Kegels.
It is. Like, hers is really nice and tight, man.
Anyway, Jessica Simpson, she's still a fat bitch, even though she had her kids. It was a damn shame. Honestly, it was a waste.
I heard
it was
an aborigine baby.
She just had her baby today. Like, give the bitch a break.
See, now I lost my train of thought. Where was I going with this?
I don't know. Just as long as it's waste of my junk being tight.
I'm going to break. I'm going to go to break every time you guys interrupt me. F it. Let's go to a break. We'll be right back at the bar live.
You're an asshole.
Big Dave. He went to go take a whiz. Good. Now I can continue.
Why?
Because he's not interrupting me.
Yeah, but we both interrupt you.
I am in a very a-hole mood today.
Well, you talk rubbish, so we do interrupt you.
Rubbish my ass.
Rubbish.
Do you have to go to the bathroom?
No.
I'll finish this with... Hey.
When men finish, it's a good thing.
Hey, there's a Y&R guy over there. They don't interrupt each other. I bet you I could get him over here on the microphone and he wouldn't interrupt me.
Well, he's actually got manners, though. You do
what?
Not.
What?
You heard me. When you left on what? Saturday, me, Brandon, and Patrick had a great show.
Sphincter say what?
Great show.
Oh, really?
Yeah, we did.
When who what?
When you left and then Lane left, there was me, Patrick, and Brandon, and we had a great show.
Well, that's awesome.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Yeah, it was good.
Did you ask him for a job?
Well, I actually have a job right now.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Are you
getting irritated with me today?
I would love to see you try and replace me.
Are you getting irritated with me today?
No.
Yeah? Am I pissing you off?
Nope.
All right, the music is like really loud. What's up with that?
You need a hearing aid, old man.
I need a nap is what I need.
Yeah, you do.
Probably a nap and a Valium after today's traffic.
I can give you Valium. That's not a problem.
So anyway, the fat bitch had their kid, and she's probably going to be fat forever. And that's I'm sorry. That's just my opinion. She already even admitted, though. She even said when she was interviewed about it, she said, look, I don't really think I want to go back to what I looked like before. Like, really?
She's a liar.
No.
Yeah.
I think she just realizes she's already passed that threshold.
No.
It's too late.
No, because
was it a C-section? Does anybody know if it was a C-section?
Well, she had a 9-pound baby, so I don't know if she pushed it out herself.
Do you happen to know if it was a C-section, Jimmy? You don't know either? I need to check that out. Find out if it was a damn C-section or not.
Well, but see, the thing is that
she's gonna have that landing strip on her stomach.
Hey, I have that landing strip. Thank you very much.
Sorry.
And I still look damn good with that clothes on.
I'm not going to say anything.
Well, you've seen me with no clothes on. Just about.
Are you expecting me to give you some kind of encouragement? I'm not going to say anything.
No.
You know, because all you do is make fun of me whenever I take my clothes off.
That's because you're a fat ass and no one wants to see you.
Yeah, well, you got a landing strip on your belly.
Yeah, I do. And I wear it with pride.
Yeah. Well, I wear my tub with pride.
Well, my last baby was actually natural.
Well, my last baby came out sideways and I didn't scream or nothing.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Was that this morning?
Yes.
I mean, I do not believe that she does not want to go back to the way that she was. Because the last thing that I wanted to do after I had my baby was stay the way that I am.
10 things. Here we go. 10 things they don't tell you about after giving childbirth. You ready?
Yep.
You can fill in here as you want. Okay, this was written by a chick, okay, who just got through having a baby. And she goes, these are 10 things they don't tell you after giving childbirth. Number one, you will have a really heavy time of the month. No matter how you give birth, you will have a postmortem bleeding. This delightful discharge is called Lochia.
Why?
Yeah, I don't know.
No,
did you not have this?
Yes, I read the story and I'm like, why?
Why what?
Why would you even like want to discuss this?
Because we're talking about, I just want you to get a good picture in your head as to what Jessica Simpson's going to be going through for the next few weeks.
I've been there, done that. Like,
just let me read the damn story.
Go for it.
Good God Almighty.
I would like to apologize.
Here we go. Your crotch could be a mess. Yeah, you may be dealing with a swollen, stitched up, mighty mess.
Nope.
That even Stephen King couldn't dream up. Yes, indeed. There you go. There's another wonderful thing.
No.
Number three. You're still fat. That's right. You will need clothes, fat clothes, maternity clothes after you've had this kid because it'll be sort of like a second trimester and you'll be doughy for a while. This is yet another reason why I hate those damn model ass hats that are wafer thin in 10 minutes after they give birth. Yeah, this chick's like really angry about having a kid.
Yeah, she is. Because I had a baby like 18 months ago and she's full of shit. Because
Sheet?
Sheet.
She's got a sheet on her. Okay.
Because, like,
I see what you're saying. Sheet.
See?
Yeah.
No. There is no like.
What did you weigh, like 20 pounds when you had your baby?
No, I was 195 pounds.
Okay. Well, I don't know. I'm moving on.
I think
you might be a special case.
Nope.
You might cry a lot is number four. That's right. Nope. A lot. Some women get off really easy with this one and don't ride the hormonal roller coaster after they've had a baby. I say to them, lucky, lucky whore.
It's an excuse.
Yeah, she's really upset. I'll tell you what. Here's another one that I found interesting that I didn't know. After a baby, a lot of women's hair falls out.
Your hair falls out whether you're pregnant or not. Deal with it, bitch.
It sounds like you're angry.
Well, this story made me angry because it's
why does this story make you angry? It's about what's going
to
happen
to
you.
No, it's not. It's about a postpartum depression bitch that decided to get there and write down some notes and put it online.
So it's irritating you.
Yeah, it does. Good, it irritates the shit out of me.
Then I'll read on. Yeah, your hair may fall out. You don't feel pretty now, do you? So you're all postpartum and doing and... And adds insult to energy, you might start.
I was gone, and you put me back on.
Is he back in the room?
What a dick.
Man. I was actually getting somewhere until you walked back in. Are you done taking a whiz? Okay, let's just keep going. So the next thing is breastfeeding might be difficult. If you choose to breastfeed your baby, be prepared for a little bit of work. Not everybody has a smooth ride. It can be anything...
That's stupid.
And it can be anything but soft bonding experience. It can also be a very hardcore experience.
This is a hateful, evil bitch that wrote this. I
kind of think it's funny. Here we go. You might also hate your husband.
Yes.
I have two theories of nature. One, babies look like their fathers when they are born, so the father is reassured that the baby is his and won't take off. Two, nature takes care of you not conceiving right after giving birth by making you want to punch his face out every time you see him.
See, postpartum bitch, but I do agree. I wanted to kill my husband shortly after I had my child. During the whole process of having in labor, I wanted to kill my husband. But then shortly after, when I was getting up at 2 o'clock in the morning and he was sleeping his fat ass in my bed, yes, I wanted to kill my husband.
So you can relate to this crazy bitch who you think is all upset.
Certain points, yes. But really? The rest of it, I think she's just a hateful, evil woman.
Okay, well, let's move on then. I got a couple more left before we're done with this little thing.
Bring it.
10 things they don't tell you about pregnancy. All right, number 8, you might be hot. No, not good hot. Gross, sweaty, fat man hot.
Nope.
Thank your hormones. Once again, they may be to blame for giving you hot flashes and making you feel like a high noon whore.
Nope.
No?
Nope.
You never had the hot flashes?
Nope.
You never felt like a high noon whore?
Nope.
No?
What is fat man hot?
Fat man? Oh, I can tell you
Please
a lot about
tell
fat
us,
man
Dave.
God,
what is fat man hot?
It's like sweaty, fat, nasty, smelly, B.O. whiskey coming out of your pores, balmy sweat.
Well, I have whiskey come out of my pores all the time.
I mean, I'm telling you, I have those experiences where, you know, I start working out, you know, and I start working out really hard, and man, next thing you know, I'm fat man hot.
And like 5 minutes in, you're like, woo!
Yeah.
That could be a great song. I'm fat man hot.
Oh. I have a smoking hot off the subject. But
okay, well let's get on here in a section. Hold on a second. Hold on to what you're gonna say.
Okay.
Because I've only got two more and I don't want to spend 20 minutes talking about something you were
Just remind me, smoking hot.
Smoking hot. Yeah. Okay, yeah. Okay. Put it in the small vault.
In the smoking hot vault.
Number 9, hard boobs. You know these crazy porn boobs you see on some women that are just gigantic and don't move? No. Well, try skipping a feeding while you're nursing, and you'll have a pretty good idea what it's like.
Yep.
Sounds cool, but it ain't so. So don't add a stripper heels to your registry. Will not for this reason anyway. Yeah, so apparently you have these hard, you know, rock hard boobs or something because you don't get a...
That is true, because if you don't feed your baby, then you actually get, and you don't pump, then you get like huge,
say that again.
Massive.
Say
your baby.
say feed your baby.
If you don't feed your baby, then you get like massive jugs, okay? But the worst thing is when you're out shopping and you hear a baby cry and then your boobs start to leak because it automatically like does.
No
that.
Way. Are you serious?
I have actually
doesn't matter whether
had that happen.
Really?
Yeah. I've been shopping, heard a baby cry, and then I lactated.
It doesn't matter whether it's your baby or not. If it's time to feed your baby and you're not there, then
You're not there. Time to feed your baby
to a dingo.
Screw you both, bitches.
Got to feed the baby
to
a dingo.
To a kangaroo.
A kangaroony.
Put him in the pouch. What?
I'm about to give Jimmy a really good shot because he's like playing with his thing over there.
Oh.
Oh, Jimmy, are you playing with your thing?
I didn't notice that.
Cool.
Maybe you should make it bigger.
No.
There you go. Yeah, just like that.
I noticed he was playing with his.
Do you like?
He was trying
like
to put it underneath the table to see if he had panties or not.
Do you like? Do you like? Do you like what you see over there?
Jimmy?
Yeah.
No, well, not so much.
Yeah? He's over there playing with
his
thing.
He's got some sexy blue eyes.
Yeah, he does.
He does have some sexy blue
eyes. Thought about those
eyes
the other night.
You thought about those eyes the other night?
That's
no, I was just thinking
sick.
About like leaning across the table and giving him a nice boob shot.
Number 10, things.
Oh,
number
that
10.
That would have been very generous of you.
Number 10 on things.
Very non-selfish.
Number 10
Hold
on things. Jesus Christ. Number Ooh, 10 on
about
Jesus
hard
fuck.
Boobs.
I swear to God, I'm going to effing lose my mind. I'm going to say the F word a million times.
She was
Where
about
the hell
to
is
show
my
a boob.
Jesus. Fuck, dude, I'm not bad. Da-da-da-da.
She was about to show a boob, dude. And you blew it.
I don't want to see her flapjacks. Thank you very much. That's number two. I did it today. Number two. That's twice in one day.
I'm cool with seeing
Bam!
Flapjacks.
Bam. Fuck. Fuck. There she goes. Oh, she's pulling out a gun.
Motherfucker, give me a lot.
Yes, ma'am.
I got.
I'm
hey,
coming. I'm hurry. I'm
Dean,
coming. I just get here.
Dean, you owe me $20. You owe me $20.
Why?
It's my I don't. Fucking black
he bet me and he lost.
I didn't bet anything, dude. You just blew a boob shot. That's all I'm saying. Is we were gonna have.
Do you
a
think she was really?
Shot.
She wasn't gonna do a boob shot.
She was doing a boob
she
shot.
Wasn't, she was gonna show the bra. She's done that before.
You know, she was going to show.
And you weren't here
was,
for that day.
She was going to lean over, and then I was going to pluck that bra right up that away.
Anyway, number 10 on things. I swear Jeez. To God, I'm just trying to get through the goddamn 10. Number 10.
Well, it's boring.
Jesus Christ.
Nobody gives a shit about this.
The hell with it. Fuck it. Go to break. You're at the bar with Big Dave. Holy shit. Break, please. Music, please. For the love of God, before I lose my damn mind.
Thank you.
So did you guys hear about Clear Channel and the Eagle?
Yeah. Putting okay. Nikki Sixx on in the morning.
Why am I quieter all of a sudden? Is it just me?
I missed the Clear Channel thing. What?
Okay, so Clear Channel, they're doing some changes on the Eagle, right?
Yeah.
Nikki Sixx is going to be going to mornings out there on 97.1 The Eagle. Of course, why does this matter to us, right? I'll tell you why, because you know Chloe.
Yeah.
Big part of, an integral part of the show. Hasn't been on because they're making changes, and we're just kind of waiting to see what's going to happen and stuff like that. So it's all good. It's all cool. You know, I mean, I don't know if he'll be able to be a part of the show or not, but I'm really kind of crossing my fingers and hoping everything works out because I'd love to have Chloe as a part of the show again.
Yeah.
And, you know, I'm not afraid to talk about it. I mean, it's not against anything for him to be talked about. It's only against the rules for him to be on the show at this point. So
we can talk about him?
Yeah, we can talk about
him.
We just can't.
He's a douche, man.
He's not. Chloe's a sweetheart, man.
I don't understand why there's such an issue, because I'm on the Saturday morning.
Well, we can't. You know,
show.
I don't want to go into details about it. There's more details that I can't.
I know.
Produce, but I'm just going to simply say that we hope the best for whatever changes are going to be taking place there. And hopefully it'll be for the positive for our show as well as theirs.
I don't want Nikki Sixx on in the morning.
Well,
Nikki
you know.
Nikki Sixx is boring.
The thing is, it's not really about Nikki Sixx being on in the morning. It's about them finally doing some changes and getting things squared away over there with Clear Channel. Because then maybe we'll have a little bit more answers as to where we're going to be going in the near future.
Right, but I still don't want Nikki Sixx on in the morning. I don't like Nikki Sixx on radio. I like Nikki Sixx.
He's actually a nice guy, man.
No, I love Nikki Sixx. Motley Crue, Nikki Sixx. 6 a.m., Nikki Sixx. I don't like radio, Nikki Sixx.
Okay, well, I mean, that's cool. I mean, everybody's you know. Totally got their opinion. I'm sure a lot of people have an opinion about this show.
Yeah, who doesn't love this show?
Right. So you got all upset a little while ago about... by the way, one more thing. On the way here, since I spent an hour and 10 minutes in traffic, I also heard the advertisement for Sunbrew, which you guys know the barlive.com is owned by Sunbrew and Sunbrew Bikini Models, the awesome Brandon Shaw. They're going to be doing a thing in Allen pretty soon. They were advertising on the Eagle. Is that correct, Jimmy? You're just, are you here?
He doesn't even know.
He doesn't know.
They're going to be doing a thing in Allen soon.
It's a thing in Allen where they're going to have the Sunbrew girls out there, and it's going to be a really cool thing. I think we may actually make a quick appearance out there.
Cool.
You know, just kind of say, hey, what's up, and all that other stuff. So be there at that awesome event. I'll give you the dates and everything.
Yeah, that'd be good. I'd like to have the date. So
it's
coming
up pretty soon.
You know when to show up. I don't want to just go hang out now.
Well, I just heard about it a little while ago, so I haven't had a chance to do any research on it.
Oh, okay. I'm just saying I didn't want to go just every weekend and hang out in Allen waiting for your call.
Such an asshole.
Well, I live in Plano, so you can
Come over and chill at your house.
Yeah,
so every weekend I'm going to be at Mel's house chilling, waiting to see what we're doing.
But I work on the Eagle in the morning on Saturdays.
That's okay. I'm not up in the morning on Saturdays.
Neither am I. Screw that crap. I'm done.
I'm up at 5 o'clock every morning on Saturday mornings.
That's why you need a web business.
God.
No.
Yeah, go to Revolution Lane. .net.
Shameless
got
plug.
A bunch of cool
if
stuff
I,
on there.
If I am up at 5 o'clock in the morning, it's only because I haven't gone to bed yet.
No, I have fun
That's
on
all.
Saturday mornings. It's good fun.
No, yeah. Screw that. I'm totally out as far as that goes. Anyway, you got all upset a little while ago, right? Because I said something about your flapjacks. Now I just kind of want to go over that real quick. I know you calmed down a little bit because I went out there and gave you a hug and you know touched your ass and all that stuff. But I'm curious, you know.
And got fat man sweat on it.
You get all upset, right? You know, whenever I make a snide remark about your looks, right? Just one. And then, but yet you sit there and go off on me like crazy. And I'm actually kind of hurt by that. You know, if you can give it, you better be able to take it too. That's my opinion.
Screw you, bitch. Your name is Big
What
Dave.
Is it? No, I mean, I'm just curious. Is it because you're a woman that you feel like you have to have the special treatment of being careful about giving you a hard time about certain things about your appearance? Do you think, you know, because I have to tread on water, on thin ice because women are emotional?
No, because I know my boobs are not the best. And then you want to sit
your
there and say,
fine.
Who wants to see my boobs on the webcam and call them flapjacks instead?
Well,
so
I know I have a muffin top, but I'm not crying every time you know, walking out of the room and screaming and throwing a fit like a 2-year-old.
you openly take your top off when we don't want you to. Like,
yeah.
I'm
proud, man. I'll go to a nudist colony. I'm not afraid.
I am not proud of my boobs.
I'm
going to
throw up.
Dude, have you ever been to a nudist beach, man? That's people like me are the only ones that go there.
Yeah.
And I'm going to throw up.
I've been a couple of times. I'll tell you, the last experience I had was a little scary, though, and that's the reason why I haven't been back in a few years. I went, and there was this old guy, probably around 57, 58 years old, and gray hair everywhere. I mean, everywhere.
The carpet matched the drapes.
I mean, oh, yeah. It was, yeah. He had, and it, not only that,
there was a gray squirrel down there.
No, actually, it was like a landing strip. He had a landing strip car.
Oh, come on.
I guess because he wore the bikini things on a regular basis. I don't know. But for some reason, it was not what you would call flaccid. Okay. You following along?
Yeah, I'm following.
And that kind of creeped me out a little bit because he was giving me the want to wear you as a hat look, you know. And that freaked me out a little bit.
Okay, so
I looked over. I looked over at my wife and I said, I think it's time for us to go.
So I'm kind of perplexed. If someone is giving you the I want to wear you like a hat look, you get creeped out. But you openly said just before we walked in the door that you wanted to wear Jimmy as a hat.
I do.
That's not creepy at all.
Mm. Hey, Jimmy, look at me. Yeah.
Yeah, see, it's only creepy. See, now, Jimmy is creeped out. See,
I bet you
it's only creepy when it's unwanted. you know what I'm saying?
Hey, Jimmy, I bet you bathe a lot, don't you?
I do.
I bet you that smells good.
Well, I would smell like, so.
Do you use lava soap?
Is it lava or is it like...
What kind of soap do you use there, dude?
Hold on, what's that real minty smell?
Iris Spring?
Yes.
I used to love some Irish Spring.
Mm, me too.
Yeah. No.
I could love some Irish Spring.
I bathe like a 15-year-old. I use Axe.
No. Axe? That smells like alcohol, man.
But that's why that's why he pulls all the bitches.
Yeah. That's why he gets so many bitches.
Am I disturbing you?
Dude.
Huh?
Am I disturbing you? Hold on. I'm going to get to the hot thing.
But
creeped me out a bit when you looked at me straight in the eyes and said that. But, you know, now I can't make eye contact with you. It's a small price to pay.
Okay.
Well, he doesn't want you to make eye contact. Trust me.
So
he wants it the other way around.
If I said I wanted to wear you like a hat, would that be different?
It's a little different.
little.
Yeah, that's
so. So let me ask you a question.
That's not creepy. See,
so let me ask you a question. Would it be a would it be a house salad or would it be more like a leafy lettuce?
What are we talking about?
I don't even know.
Come on, she's wearing you as a hat.
A leafy lettuce?
No, I'm just kind of curious. Would it be like a house salad or would it be like a grilled chicken salad?
No, he's talking about me, baby.
I'm talking about. Would she be tossing the house salad or the chicken Caesar?
Oh, well, I guess that's up to her. While she's down there, might as well have a free for all. You never know what's gonna happen.
You never know.
Yeah.
And just remember, I have no gag reflex. So.
Wow.
Damn, I love it when you say that. No, but see, there's a big difference. It's like
I'm lost.
When the room goes silent.
Yeah.
You know, it's like if I say, Mel, you know, man, you're smoking hot. I'd love to wear you as a hat, okay? Not as creepy as if I go, hey, I want to wear you as a hat. You know what I'm talking about right now.
it's like those creepy construction workers, you know, the chicks walk by and they're like, they're serious.
You know what? And you know
they
what?
Really,
I've always
they really
wondered
want to take
is,
you. Does, they really want to take you home, and they really want to like do bad things to you.
Right, but does that ever work for them? Is what I wonder.
Yeah.
You know, it's like you at some point you think you'd give up. You know, you're like, oh, baby, look at how stuff. Hey, I hit that. And I mean, and like, do women actually go, oh, what? You would? Oh, my God. I've wanted to be, you know, molested by some nasty, fat construction worker. That was what I was hoping for today.
But if they're in a uniform, it makes it a whole lot different.
Really? Oh, well, so if they're wearing a hard hat, it kind of turns you on a little?
Yeah.
Okay, well, I'm going to wear my uniform next week.
Same here. Yeah. Yeah. Just for the record, I'm not gay. I really don't want to wear him as a hat. I just I wanted to see Jimmy squirm.
Liar. He's such a liar.
He's so
he's been going on about how sexy Jimmy is since we started this show.
Hold on. Really. I am totally secure I got the hiccups from strawberry wine, Boone's Farm. I am totally secure as a straight male. So, I mean, I can joke about this. You know, now, here's the thing. If I was gay, I would have already been out a long time ago.
Yeah, but see, here's the thing. A lot of straight men that I'd know would not comment on how sexy they think Jimmy is.
No, you would say something like,
he's a good-looking guy.
Yeah, but that's the difference. You go, he's a good-looking dude. You know, Jimmy's a good-looking guy. He's a good-looking guy. I'm fine with saying that.
Now, Lane, on the other hand, Lane looks more like, what's that guy's
dude,
name?
Dude, I'm a hard nine.
Scarface.
You want to know?
I'm a hard nine, dude. Hard nine.
As a woman, you want to know what makes the panties wet about Jimmy?
What?
His eyes.
His eyes?
His eyes.
His eyes. What about my eyes?
Yeah, not so much. Jimmy has the bluest eyes
bullshit,
I have ever
seen.
He has the bluest eyes I have ever seen. Oh, and he has a really hot ass.
I got some really blue eyes, though. What about me?
Yeah, not so much.
Well, what about me, man? Don't I got anything, man? I got some good guns.
Dude, you got those brown eyes.
Your tats are really sexy.
Okay, thank you. See, now
but
I feel better about myself.
Jimmy has, like, the sexiest blue eyes and a really hot ass.
Have you seen the tat that I have down here?
Not so much. Does it say this way and an arrow pointing?
No, it doesn't. have you seen it?
No.
Okay. You gotta watch.
It says, I wish I was bigger.
No, it doesn't.
I don't know what it says. It's a long... Can you even read what it says, Lane? What does it say? Read it.
No, okay. It says, objects below are larger than they appear.
Can we get a camera shot of that? Let's get a camera shot of that.
He literally has that tattooed on his belly. That is awesome.
I never saw that before.
That is awesome.
I'm glad I never saw it before. Yeah, do we have to get a close-up on that so people can read it? Now that is not camera effects. If you're watching, that's not camera. That's real. That's a real tattoo. He literally had that done. Wow, that is stupid and great all at the same time.
I didn't mean to rub your belly.
That is awesome. I need to get one of those.
That is dead sexy.
Who did that? I would probably go that route. I would do that. I'll put it right there on my muffin top.
I did it, and I did it in the lettering like on your rearview mirror.
That is awesome.
But let me tell you, it friggin' hurt.
Did it really?
Oh, bad. It hurt bad.
I have to agree with that because I have one on my hip, or I have two separate ones on my hip, and they hurt like a mofo.
So if I got a tattoo, babe, would you think that was a little sexy if I got a tattoo?
Not so much.
I mean, I'm trying to find something about me that you find somewhat, you know, pretty. I want to feel pretty.
You have a sexy head.
Hold on. I want to feel pretty when I'm around you, Mel. Oh. You don't make me feel pretty. You make me feel just fat and ugly. And I'm beginning to get hurt about that because most people find something pretty about me they like.
Well, see, the thing is that you're kind of like my big brother. So
have you ever had sex with your big brother? Because I could be your big brother.
No.
No? Okay. All right.
Have you had sex with your big brother?
A couple times.
Yeah. There's things that I find like really sexy about a man. One is I'm an ass girl. Two, I'm like really attracted to eyes. And three is tattoos. And plus, if they throw me around, then that's a big bonus too. But
so if I stare you in the eyes long enough, maybe you might find something exciting about my eyes, maybe?
No, you got a puncture in the head.
No, because... Jeez. When Lane spanked me at the beginning of the show, you know, that was...
I asked to spank you.
Yeah, no, you spanking me is turn
You wouldn't let me spank you. I wanted to spank you. No. I want to spank you with my bare hands.
No,
I want to spank you hard. I want
to
spank you.
I've met your wife, and she's a crazy bitch, and she would probably kill me.
No, she
would. And
like
I would need
that.
To carry my
home,
380 with me everywhere.
No, if I go home and tell her I spanked you tonight, she's going to be like all hot and bothered about that.
No, yeah, she'll be hot and bothered, but not in the right way.
No, she will. She'll say spank me too.
No.
Spank me with the same hand.
No. See, Not so much.
Spank me with the same hand.
Can I smell your hand?
I doubt that she would say that.
Can I smell your hand?
Okay, let's segue into something else because
Hold on. I was going somewhere, but hold on a second.
I don't like these chairs. They make my skirt right up.
Yeah,
I have that effect on women. Well, if I had a dime for every time a chick said my skirt's riding up every time I'm around you.
Honey, it's just me making your skirt ride up.
No, this chair makes my skirt like right up to my panties, and it's not good.
It's all good. What I was saying was, is the thing is, a lot of, look, I didn't know that you were so, you know, upset about your flapjack. No, I mean your breasts, your boobs. I know you, by the way, you got that boob job coming up pretty soon, right?
Yes.
So I'm not going to be able to call him that anymore?
No.
Damn, that sucks. Man.
I'm thinking of going to Tijuana. Tijuana to get my boobs done.
Yeah, no, don't do that. You'll come back with like one Mexican boob and one like
a chihuahua.
White boob. You have like a chihuahua head over here and like one will be bigger than the other.
A Saint Bernard and a chihuahua.
Yeah, it would be it'll probably have a crease in it, look like a taco on one side. Yeah. You don't know.
So the reason why I'm asking is because did you know that they've done research just recently?
Uh-huh.
And I found this the other day cuz I was thinking about you. Many women would trade their IQ points for bigger breasts.
Yep.
It's true. A new survey found that a third of women would lower their IQ if it meant that the size of their breasts would increase. 41%, more than 2,000 women who answered an unscientific online survey said that they would like to have bigger breasts, and more than a quarter of women said that they would want to trade IQ points for a more generous chest. There you go. I mean, it just goes to show you how vain women are versus men.
See, but you know what my big thing is after I get my boob job, is that I need to massage them, like, every, like, hour or so.
We'll do that. We can do that on the show.
Take care of that. We'll handle that. It's all good. See,
we help you out.
You got friends.
We're friends. Yeah.
Okay.
It's all about being a friend.
Look, we're givers. You understand that? We are givers.
We are.
Okay.
Just wear the same skirt.
Just take one. Yeah. This was my work gear.
Bet.
This is what I wear to work.
Yeah,
I
bet.
So, no, I have to.
Well, $20, give me.
Look professional.
$20.
Really?
Yeah, that was funny.
You just called me a whore.
Yeah. No, I didn't call you a whore.
I'm a high class escort. Thank you very much.
Yeah, it's $22, dude.
$22.75.
Pennies anymore, bitches. When I get my boobs, I'll be charging even more.
It'd be $27.50 when she gets a diss.
maybe we'll have Like Bridges We Burn On. We're playing one of their songs right now in the background. Like Bridges We Burn On.
Oh, no, they've already burnt that bridge.
We need to get that guy from Jibe back again. He was really nice. I can't.
No, he's cool. He's cool as hell. Mm-hmm. Jibe's a cool band.
Yep.
I was just playing a lot of them there, too.
We need to get him back on.
So speaking of hot, man, you had something you want to say. Let's get it out of the system, man.
Oh,
get it out of the system. Do you remember now?
Okay. I met this chick, and she's a personal trainer, and she's smoking hot.
This better be good.
She is ripped, okay?
Give me some of that benchmark.
And she would like to come on the show.
Yeah, I would like to come on the show, too.
And do a little workout. You know, with us.
Really?
Yeah.
Is she gonna wear the workout Jane Fonda G?
I don't care what she wears. This chick is like.
How's she gonna do a workout? How's that gonna be entertaining? That's what I want to know.
Because
is she gonna make me
funny?
Do it?
Yeah, because you're gonna do it with us.
I'm gonna.
Everybody's gonna do it. Yeah.
All right. So you want now if she's really hot. I may go along with this, but she's gonna have to touch me in places that I'm not familiar with. All right.
Yeah, you'll be sore.
I will
all over the next day. Yeah.
Will I get some good rest though?
Yeah, you'll get perfect sleep.
She have a happy ending?
Yeah, she's a very happy person.
Yeah?
Yeah.
that's not what he's talking
about. I'm in like Gunga Din. Let's do it.
Okay. All right. Cause I mean, dude, she's literally like just shredded. I was like, whoa. She was at one of the gigs, you know, and I was like, oh. You should come on the show, and Mel would love to have you.
You know, we did this thing out at the Harley Davidson place this last week. Was it on Saturday or Sunday?
It was on Saturday, and it was a huge success when you left. Sorry.
You know, it's always nice to think of yourself as that way. That's great.
Just saying.
Who was the one who got it started?
Ask
even though
Jimmy.
With, hey, no, wait. No, I'm
Jimmy
curious.
Was there
I'm curious. Who was the one who got it started to the point where it could be a huge success?
When
with no instruction whatsoever.
When you left,
Jimmy was taking
and Lane
a nap.
Left, there was me, Brandon, and Patrick from our other show, Y&R.
A bunch of professionals.
If you haven't, shut up. If you have not checked out Y&R Radio, you need to check them out because they're on just before us.
Who?
Really hot, sexy boys, too. So, Y&R Radio.
Who?
You're Never Right.
Who?
Radio.
Exactly.
Really
I've never
sexy
heard of them
boys.
Yeah, I don't know.
And they're on just before us, so you need to check them out, too.
Yeah, okay.
So they're girly boys.
So they're girly boys?
Little pretty boys.
But Patrick.
I'm beat their ass.
Patrick.
We'll show up, let's show up here early and
beat their ass.
We'll do it on. We'll do it live.
We used to
You know, hold on. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to bring. I'm going to go buy one of those sex dolls, right? All right, and this is between us, all right? Shh.
Okay, shh.
You remember what I did back when we were doing the Big Dave and Chloe show over at Rational?
Yes.
With the sex doll?
Yeah.
Okay.
All awesome.
Right. We're going to do it.
Why?
Let's get one of those.
You're never going to expect it either, man. It's just going to pop up. Bam.
Let's get one of those blow-up sheep, too.
Oh, yeah. Put it right behind the... Get a little strap on.
Yeah.
Y&R Radio is nothing like our show. They're extremely professional, unlike us. And they're organized. And Patrick said that was the one thing about their show is they're organized.
Yeah,
so
screw that.
There was me, Patrick, and Brandon from Sunbury Living. No, Action.
That's awesome.
Action,
I'm bored now.
Yeah, me too. I am like totally like, it sounds like it was way too boring.
Action Sunbury Living, I don't know, something that's like
Action Boring.
Brandon's
Action
show.
Boring now.
But after you left on Saturday. Bored. It was really, really good.
Did y'all have, like, sex on camera or something?
No.
Well, then it wasn't that good.
Did you show crack? What? Yeah. I don't know.
What's good about it? Chicks dancing on the tables, taking their tops off?
Why?
No, because I had two, like, nice pieces of meat. Well, three, because Jimmy was sitting on the other side. I was, like, smooshed in between three big pieces of man candy.
Would you rather be a part of a professional show?
Well, no, that's why I'm here.
Okay. All right. I'm just making sure. I'm trying to find out what you're trying to say to me right
I'm
now.
I'm trying to be nice to our other, like, family that's
look,
on our show.
Look, we love
Y&R
now. Radio. We're planning on giving them a lot of hell, and I'm sure they'll give us the same. I mean, look at Actual Living. All they do is give us hell. I mean,
I
their entire shows
but
are built
you know
around
what?
Us.
They're,
I watched
they're
Jimmy's.
Douchebags.
Hold on. I watched Jimmy's show, like,
well,
from 2 weeks
Jimmy's a
ago.
Douchebag, too.
No, Jimmy is, like, the Matrix Neo, like, crap. He had a beer can thrown at him, and if you watch the actual segment, he like Keanu
did he do
Reeves
a flip
that shit. No, you should have seen it.
Oh,
I don't
just
know
knocked it out of the way.
How
that's not
the
impressive.
Hell.
If he'd have done a flip and landed and knocked it out of the
it
way, then that
like
would have been cool.
Pegged straight at his head, and I have no idea how the hell.
How
he
did you live
there.
Through that? How did you live through that?
Very carefully. Basically, what happened was is we were in the middle of a broadcast, and the camera is basically in between me and a drunk guy, and the drunk guy is just like stumbling around in front of the camera. I'm like, "Hey, dude, could you move back?" And he starts getting louder, and he's trying to talk to all of us. Meanwhile, we all have
this was at the Harley Davidson thing.
No.
This is in Deep Ellum where we do live shows on Thursdays. And
wow, okay.
Yeah, so
the element of unknown.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was pretty crazy. So this guy
okay.
is he's on his own, he's wasted, and he's not understanding.
Was he like a homeless looking dude or anything like that?
No, he's just one of those guys.
Drunk assholes.
He's one of those like one of the drunk guys that most people don't want to run into in a place like Deep Ellum. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's what usually talks them out of going.
Yeah.
But yeah, so basically the people at the bar ended up kind of picking up on the whole thing, and they were like, "Hey dude, why don't you come over here? And it's the other side of the outside of this bar, and he's kind of contained on one corner. And the next thing I know, a beer bottle goes flying in the air. And I'm like, what the hell's going on over there? I just figure everyone's getting drunk, having a good time or whatever. And then one goes slinging straight by me, like right by me.
Literally.
And just barely missed it. I mean, I just like dodged it like at last second. And I was kind of impressed with how quick I realized, you know.
Little reflexes.
That's like some George Bush shoe dodging thing going on.
Okay,
yeah,
if you
impressive.
Haven't seen it, you need to go to It's Stuck in the Web on Jimmy's page. Uh-huh. You can find Stuck in the Web and watch this. It is crazy.
Stuck in the butt?
Well, I got to see that. I got to see that because I'm sure that's funny as hell.
Crazy shit. Like, he literally just goes, whoa, and, like, gets really pissed off.
Yeah.
You can see the look on his face.
Did you throw one
like
back?
No. They basically ended up pushing the guy off to the other side, and we were kind of watching over it, but, like, I'm in mid-sentence as I have to dodge. And then I come back up, and I try to finish my thought, and right in the middle of it, I realize, man, I This is the first time, probably since high school, that I want to fight. Yeah. I want to get into a fight.
You could see the look
got
on
up
his
and beat
face.
The hell out of
was
you.
Like,
I would have done. I'd have been like,
you know,
screw that.
I had the great thing about working in bars on a regular basis is you do learn real quick how to put people in their place when they're drunk and you're not. And sometimes when you're drunk and they're drunk, you learn how to be the upper hand. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, they may think they're crazy because they're drunk, but no, you ain't running to me, mother. You know what I'm saying? Had this crazy bitch a couple of weeks ago, comes up to my show, you know, and I hate karaoke. I do it because it pays the bills. And on top of that, it's entertaining sometimes, right? But every once in a while, I run into what I call karaoke queens. These are the bitches that think they are the best singer in the world. And if they don't get up to sing at least a certain amount of times that they feel is necessary, they're going to go off on you like you're a stepchild that they want to beat the hell out of. Okay, so this bitch comes up to me at the end of the show. I only got to her once. She handed me a $30 bill to get up once in the first place because they have like a shitload of people that come to my shows. You know that.
Yeah.
And I told her, I said, I'm not going to be able to get to you again, but I'll take the $30. I'll go ahead and bump you up this time, but I'm not going to do it again. No problem. Okay. She comes up to me at the end of the show. I was supposed to be up a second time, blah, 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 blah. And for the first time in a long time, I just lost it. And it takes a lot to make me lose it.
Okay. Maybe. Yeah, not really.
Maybe not.
That was a lie.
I finally just went off. Oh, my God. I went off. I actually felt bad the next day because her husband was right there, and he was so scared of me that he wouldn't intervene, even though I was calling her a bitch, a whore,
well,
you know,
that
telling her to get her slutty ass off
see,
my effing stage. And yeah, I was pissed.
You shouldn't feel bad for him because there's two things that happened there. Either he, like, knew she was being a bitch and was like, well, I hope this dude knocks her ass out, you know. Or
yeah, it could have been.
Or he's just a big giant vajayjay, because I don't care who is talking to my old lady. I'll tell her, okay, what you need to do is you need to go start the car. Because somebody's about to get clocked and I'm gonna need to leave real quick.
Well, I was a little nervous, but when I noticed that he was just kind of looking at me like, you know, I think you're right and she's wrong, you know, I just kept going. So.
Yeah, well, he was probably like, man, she's being a stupid bitch. And
yeah, I was trying to be kind. I was trying, hey, let's go to a break real quick. You're at thebarlive.com, thebarlive.com. You're at the bar with Big Dave right here along with Mel and Lane and the incredible Jimmy behind the board. I'm going to go ahead and play something here during the break, okay? So go ahead and bring it up here. Bring it up. Be good. Let's do this thing. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back. The number, once again, 214-736-3569, right? Is that right? 736-3569. Feel free to give us a call. If you're listening, we'll throw you on here for a little while. Be back in a minute.
Slip inside an open window. Move quiet.
TheBarLive.com. I am Big Dave. Here at the bar with Big Dave, the awesome Mel, and Lane hanging out with me. Jimmy behind the board. The number 214-736-3569. Feel free to call in. Is it Skype that they're calling in on there? Yeah, you can use your regular phone to call in on that. It's no big deal. You can use a landline, too. It doesn't matter. Just call the phone number like
Does
normal.
Does anybody have a landline anymore?
Yes. You know, that's something I really don't know. I know. I haven't had one in probably 7 years.
Do you know what I saw? The rarest thing ever. I went to this little bitty great barbecue place. It's called Wilson's Barbecue. They had a payphone.
A payphone. Those are
Shut
hard. They
up.
Are.
No, right there on the wall, payphone.
They are pretty hard to find.
Yeah.
They are pretty hard to find. Yeah. Anyway, this segment brought to you by Benchmark tonight, right here. This segment brought to you by Benchmark and so.
And Paul Mall.
By the way, this is really good stuff, man.
It is.
Well, see, it is made by the Buffalo Trace.
Right, now, I don't want you to go into like detail or anything.
Well, no,
it's really good stuff.
Buffalo Trace is a good, you know, it's good whiskey, and
all I know is it's very flavorful. Have you tried the new whiskey that tastes like honey?
Yeah.
It's got like a honey taste to it. You can drink it straight. It's great.
Yeah, but the great thing about this, you get this bottle is like $8.
$8?
Yeah. The big giant like gallon, which is what I usually buy.
Oh, that's awesome.
And then pour it in here. $12.99.
Yes. You know, we're going to have Rogue Radio on the show pretty soon, too.
Oh, I love those guys.
Yeah, you guys have heard about my new venture with Rogue Radio,
yes,
right?
Yes, I have.
This started about 2 weeks ago.
Is it going good?
Yeah, oh, man, we had a blast our debut night.
I wish I was invited to it because I would have come out, but you didn't tell me.
I invited everybody
no,
to it,
didn't.
Man.
No, you didn't.
You did
freaking
not.
Invite anybody.
No.
Look, it was an awesome. Look, we're going to have another one coming up in a couple of weeks. Come by and hang out with us because we had a great time. I drank
on
a horn.
I have to know where it is and when.
I'll be honest with you.
It's in Allen, one weekend.
Yeah, one weekend in Allen.
No, it's not.
So I'll be at Mel's house, hanging out, waiting for your text.
Hold on. Okay, here it is. May 28th, you guys can come out to Papa G's in Watauga. Just take Roost Snow at 820, okay? Go to 820.
Okay, yeah,
it's
can do that.
I'm sorry. No, it's on the 29th. It's on a Tuesday.
Can we win the Hawaii trip, too?
You guys can win the Hawaii trip. You guys aren't associated with me, with the show that I do out there. They're giving away a trip to Hawaii that night. You gotta just fill out an entry form.
Uh-huh. We're gonna do a duet, and we're gonna sing "Summer Lovin'."
Okay, well, listen up. I'm gonna tell you all about it. Just hold on a second. So May 29th, you guys can come out to Papa G's. I'm talking. Just take 820 to Roost Snow, and go north on Roost Snow for about 5 miles. You're gonna see on your left hand side. Well, for other people listening, moron, you dumbass. So, but anyway, yeah, matter of fact, last show that we had was so crazy that I now have made a new rule that I'm no longer drinking at my shows. Yeah, it was that crazy. I got plastered. I mean, I was drunk as crap. We had these horns that, you know, because Rogue Radio has these horns.
How does crap get?
Dude, you know, Rogue Radio has these horns, right, that they drink out of.
Yeah.
Right? And somebody was spiking my horn with, like, a buttload of whiskey. Plus, on top of the 12, 15 rumplements I have in a night,
how much
I was
is
done.
A buttload?
But
is it
just
like
me?
A little more than a shitload?
For me, it's
or
a
little
lot.
Less than a shitload.
Depends on if you're talking about mine or not.
Is it just me, but horn and Dave's butt is never...
I know. It's,
like,
it was very phallic. It's like somebody spiked my horn and my butt...
a load of whiskey.
Tell you what, the bottom line is I am not drinking at my shows anymore. Especially not when I'm working with them.
Well, why don't you just...
These guys are crazy. I don't know how they do it. You know, this is a true fact, and we'll talk about it on the show when he comes on the show. Did you know that Ken, the lead singer, you know, not only is he like 54 and looks like he's like 27,
right?
Which is totally boggles my mind. But on the same, it's in their back room, they have their own studio set up behind their house,
yeah.
Right? You go into their studio, I swear to God, all the guys out there are going to love this. You've seen those water coolers, right? Where they get the big 5 gallon jug of water, right?
Yeah.
He has a whiskey cooler.
Hell yeah, my
That's
kind
what
of man.
I'm talking about.
It's a
right
5 gallon
there.
Jug of whiskey, and it's always filled, man.
Yeah, but see, that's what keeps. I mean, I don't look my age, and it's because of sex, drugs, and rock and roll.
It's true. You're like 54.
Not 54. 53. You're an asshole.
I don't know.
No,
I'm just
saying. 44.
You got the gray hairs on your pubes, man. You know that.
I don't because I manscape.
You got the landscape?
Yeah.
I mean, you got the landing strip?
No, I don't have. I just keep it trimmed, you know?
You get a landing strip.
No, I don't have a landing strip.
Junk, I have a really good sex toy that goes with men's junk.
Good. We're going to get to that here in just a second.
Okay.
Right now, I was just talking about the drinking.
You got it with you?
No, well, no.
Oh, never mind then.
So we were talking about the drinking, the benchmark, and everything like that, and how I got totally wasted. And my God, it was like really bad. And I'm never going to do that. I was really embarrassed, to be honest with you. So no more drinking in my shows. Get this. I ran across a story the day after I got plastered, and I was like, oh my God, these kids have no idea what they're doing.
Nope.
The new thing with teens. Used to be sniffing glue. Oh, hell no. No. Now they're turning to hand sanitizer, right? I know this came out like a week and a half ago, but we were gone last week, but I really want to talk about it. They're drinking hand sanitizer to get drunk.
That would make me vomit, man. How much hand sanitizer you got to drink to get drunk?
They're mixing it with other stuff. So
yeah, but I mean, seriously, like, how much hand sanitizer do you...
Not a lot, because it's like 99% alcohol.
It can be as high as 120 proof, man. That's 65% ethyl alcohol.
Oh, well, maybe I'll start drinking.
It's like $4 for a big, like, huge jar of it.
Yeah,
like,
well, no
Dollar
wonder.
Dollar General.
That's good.
No, but that's the thing. Let's think about that a minute.
No, you know what's...
So I got to pay like, you know, $35-40 for a decent-sized bottle of Rumplemintz, right? Which is about 110 proof. I can get a little bottle of this stuff for like $3.99.
At least.
Which has more alcohol in it. And it's like, you know, a percent of the price.
At least your mouth would be nice and clean and
yeah,
free of
you'd
all
be
germs.
Sanitized. You wouldn't have any bacteria.